It has been a debateful day at Parliament today as legislators discussed the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023. The Anti-Homosexuality Bill has been approved with a maximum sentence of death to persons convicted of aggravated homosexuality. The bill described aggravated homosexuality as an act committed on a child when the offender is a parent, a guardian, or relative of a person on whom the act has been committed. The person on whom the offense has been committed suffers mental health illness, contracts a terminal illness, or the person who has committed the offense is a serial offender. The House also approved that the person who commits attempted aggravated homosexuality will be liable to 14 years imprisonment upon conviction.
We tried as much as possible not to offend provisions of the Constitution. As much as possible. Because the enemies of this bill, we know where they are going after here. And that has nothing to do with the Honorable Fox. But the enemies of the bill, the promoters of homosexuality, we know their path. And their path is a court of law. So we did our best, Madam Chairperson.
Parliament has also passed 20 years imprisonment on a person who commits the offense of homosexuality and 10 years for a person who has been convicted of attempted homosexuality. A person convicted of promotion of homosexuality will be penalized with 20 years imprisonment. A child found guilty of homosexuality will be imprisoned for 3 years. Recruiting children into the act will be jailed for 20 years, and the owner of the premises that promote homosexuality will be imprisoned for 10 years.
10 years for attempted. I put a question that clause 2 be amended as proposed by the committee and amended by the Attorney General with the 10 years on attempted. Those in favor say aye, the contrary nay. Nice have it.
Clause 2 as amended.
I put a question that clause 2 as amended stands part of the bill. Those in favor say aye, the contrary nay. Nice have it.
Clause 3.
Media houses that publish material that promotes homosexuality will be fined 1 billion shillings and have the license of that particular house revoked for a period of 10 years. The clause that had been proposed for the extradition of persons charged with homosexuality was deleted. However, the House rejected the proposal by the Tory woman MP Sarah Opendi to castrate people who are found guilty of homosexuality.
Where somebody has got your child, imagine the child is 2 years, is 3 years, even life imprisonment is not adequate. Because this person is going to go into the prison and continue living his life, maybe even continuing with homosexuality in the prisons. These people should be castrated.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.
The amendment I'm proposing is that the person should be castrated, Madam Speaker.